everybody. Today we're going to talk about vessels. Everybody knows that the vessels consist of the endothelium, smooth muscle and tunica externa. However, what most people don't know is the importance of the perivascular adipose tissue. It has been described that PFAT diminishes blood vessel contraction through unknown relaxing factors. To study these compounds, we propose to take arteries from either post-mortem or transplanted human kidneys. Some of these arteries will have PFAT and some won't. We will study them in vitro using an Orkin bath, and we will check their contractility via PE stimulation. We expect to see less contraction in the vessels with PFAT. Then, to gain some insights into the nature of the relaxing factors and the pathways it uses, we will take the medium of the Orkin baths from the vessels with and without PFAT, both before and after stimulation with PE. With this medium, we will do MSMS to identify potential candidate peptides by comparing the spectrum of vessels with and without PFAT. Then we will synthesize the candidate peptides and evaluate their vasoactivity in organ beds again, expecting to see less contraction in the muscle cells. In addition, we would use inhibitors for ENOS and components of the tyrosine kinase pathway, which could give us a hint about the mechanistics of the relaxing factor. On the other hand, we will do an expression microarray of the vessels before and after PE stimulation and also with and without PFAT. Identifying the genes whose expression is significantly up or downregulated would complement our knowledge of the pathways or mechanisms involved in the action of the perivascular adipose tissue relaxing factor. As always, there are some limitations to this research. First, human kidney samples can be tricky. In both postmortem tissue and in kidneys taken out after transplant, the functionality of the vessels might not be preserved. In addition, the medium isolated might be too diluted to detect the potential factors by MS. Lastly, the pathway studied might not be the only pathways involved, and the tyrosine kinase pathway is complex and hard to study. Despite these limitations, we think this approach will help us to understand more about the function of the perivascular adipose tissue.